And here on. So welcome everyone to our last meetup for this year. And we have a really cool topic this time about the theme generator. I already also wrote it in the summary over on Meetup that good theming of the report is always an underestimated topic, but a very important one. I've seen some reports that were great in terms of DAX, but they were unreadable in terms of the actual themes used. And this tool, however, makes it a lot easier to create really good themes and also consistent themes within a company, for example. And so I'm very happy that we have you as a speaker. And as I hand over to you, Thomas.
Okay. So hello, everybody. And thanks, Christoph, for your introduction. Today, I would like to give you a short overview of our best practice on report design, and I would like to introduce you to our PowerBrand theme generator, as Christoph said. But at first, let me introduce myself. My name is Thomas Kiewitz, and I've been working in Hamburg for 5 years as a consultant with focus on business intelligence, Azure, and Office 365. So, as I said, I would like to show a few points right away that you should or can pay attention to when creating reports. It is clear to me that in everyday life, you cannot pay attention to these points for all requirements of the business departments. For this reason, I think we see the following points rather as a guideline. So I would like to mention the success factors of Professor Dr. Hirschert. The success factors, according to Professor Hirschert, provide a first basis of implementing a successful report design. So what are these factors? So the first point is say, to convey a message. Do you have something to report? So often reports are just collections of data with no discernible messages to the recipients. So this is also true for most presentations. The next point is unify. Apply semantic notation. So similar things are presented in the same way and dissimilar things may not be presented in the same way. So unified design rules facilitate creation and understanding. So next point is condense. Increase information density. So what is this? High information density enables the presentation of complex facts. So only overview of the role allows a correct evaluation of detailed information. Check to ensure visual integrity. So report recipients expect correct data in terms of content, but is the correct data also presented correctly? And manipulated diagrams are commonplace in business communication. The next one is express. Choose proper visualization. So good visualization starts with choosing the type of chart or table that conveys the desired message and underlying facts as quickly as possible. Simplify, avoid clutter. So what is this? The readability of diagrams and tables is facilitated by Simplify. So removing noise and redundancy frees report objects from the avoidable clutter. And the last point is structure. Organize your content. Reports and presentations often do not have a logical structure, so overlaps and incompleteness make it difficult to understand business communications. So, in short, what can we do to meet these points? And I put here some examples. The first one is spaces between visuals and other elements. This is the structure I mentioned before. Or something like, do not use different colors. Work instead with intensities of colors. And from our opinion, do not use 3D effects or not many 3D effects in your visuals. So one important point is information has priority over design because we want to show information to the recipient. And so that has the priority. And the last point, and I think for me, it's one important point is use blue and red instead of green and red for showing positive and negative measures. So the topic here is color blindness. And if you want more information, go to colorblindness.com and check out the color blindness simulator. It's very interesting to see how people with color blindness see your reports, for example. So as I said at the beginning, at the beginning, not all points can always be met. So for example, the department may want a different presentation that you would recommend. So in this case, it can also be helpful to involve the users of a report more in the creation of the reports because they want something different. Or the data cannot be represented better. So I think in my opinion, trying to follow as many rules as possible can result in a good and sustainable report design. And finally, I think you can concentrate on two main goals. The first goal is the report consumer is directed by the report editor through the report. For example, by drill through or drill downs. And the report can also be understood without a title or further explanation of the report. So the report consumer can see with one look what's the report about. So, but how can we design our reports in Power BI according our defined colors and settings? So as you surely know, there are a lot of settings for each visual in Power BI. And now for each visual, I could set the setting once and export then as a JSON file. I can send this file to each report creator and they can use it. But if I have changes, for example, due to changes in my corporate identity, a manual change in Power BI is not easy and not fast. For example, one point more, I have no built-in function in Power BI to set overall settings, for example, for visuals. Example, I have one report with 5 subpages with each 2 tables. Now I want to change my background color of the columns and the form family. So I have to change the settings in every table, in every report. And this demands a high workload when I have many reports in my company. But I have an import and export function for my JSON file in Power BI. So on the internet, you can find some theme generators that help you to create a JSON file for Power BI, but they all have some disadvantages. They are not up to date and they do not allow later editing of an existing file. So we developed our own generator, which I would like to present you now. You can start from scratch or upload an existing theme file, and the generator is available as a web application at themegenerator.point-gmbh.com. But the best is it's completely free to use. And now I want to give you a short demo of our theme generator, and then you can see how it works. So first of all, I've got here an example report, a little one with a table and a bar chart. And now I'm going to show you our theme generator and how we can change one or two options of these visuals. So I open Chrome, and at first, this is our start page of the theme generator. In the left navigation area, you have the choice of all standard visuals that are available in Power BI. If you select a visual, you have the possibility to define all settings of this visual in the middle area, for example, my table visual. So here are all settings that are available in Power BI for this visual, and you can, for example, expand all settings, and you see you have many, many different options to set your lookalike of the table. So now I will set a few settings for my table. For example, I collapse all, and for example, I change the background color for the column headers of my table, maybe to gray, like EB. I set maybe the color of the values of the data to the form family to Verdana. And the text size maybe to 12. And I also do it at the column headers, the form family, Verdana, and the column headers, I expand it to maybe 40. So additionally, maybe I change the setting for the last row, for the total row, that are the total labels. And I also change it here to Verdana and set it a bit higher. And now I can download my JSON file in the upper area. So here I can download my JSON file, give it a name. I leave it with download.json. I download my theme file. And now I have a JSON file with all my settings. And now I can import in Power BI, in my Power BI report. So I choose now my download.json, my JSON file. And yeah, now we have to look at our column headers and, for example, at our total rows. And as you see, my settings that I declined in the theme generator are applied to my table. And now when I start, for example, a new report, and I choose a table, choose also a table with a maybe category and, for example, the discount. So you see that every table now I create in Power BI has also the design that I set in my Power BI theme generator. So let's say I created a JSON file now with all my settings, and but now I need to change the setting for some visuals, for example, for my column chart here on the right. So for this, I have the easy way in our generator to upload the JSON file. This option is here. I also start the Power Generator new. So I can now here start to upload my JSON file. So the generator now recognizes all settings, and I can now change them and download my new JSON file and pass it back to Power BI. For example, now we check first the settings of my total labels that I've done it before. So here you see the theme generator recognized my settings as I made, as I've done it before. And now maybe I go to the column chart, and maybe I do it now for the title of the column chart. I set it also the background color to gray. And maybe I give it a placeholder text for the title so that the report creator see, oh, okay, I can now here give it a title. And maybe I change also the font family to Verdana and leave the font size at 40 PET. And now I download my theme. I give it a new name. New. And now I import it back to Power BI. So as you see, now my column chart already get the new settings, which I declined in the theme generator. And so that's all. That's the whole magic, I say. And I hope I could give you a short overview of how our theme generator works, and I already try to invite you to try it yourself, because I think this tool, it makes more fun to to build a report and to build good designed reports, and it is not so frustrating when you have to edit some themes you already have in your whole company. So I hope I could give you a short overview how theme generator works, and how it can help you with designing and redesigning your own reports. And if you found bugs and or you have other ideas to improve the generator, please feel free to contact us. And then I said thanks for listening, and happy theming.
Yes, thank you. This was a shorter meetup, but it was also planned.
I'm a quick speaker, sorry.
No problem. No, it was already, we know it's a shorter meetup. Maybe maybe some questions from the chat. So let's give him a few minutes to maybe ask some questions, or maybe they want to see something. Maybe from my side. Do you have, from your experience, some tips on things that you, I mean, you already showed it in the beginning, a few things you should avoid or you should do in a report. Mm-hmm. Is there something what you also have as a quick tip, what you've seen that doesn't work or what that works very good? So I agree with you, for example, with the colors. I try to work with very little colors and with high contrast, kind of to separate also things within a report that belong to different things. But do you also have kind of a nice, maybe not super obvious tip to design a report or something?
In my opinion, I think it's like you said, to start with, yes, with not so many colors, but this is most the problem with the departments. They want, yes, very colorful reports, dashboards with many, many informations and maybe text boxes and explanations. And I think that's the most problem to work with the departments and to recommend to do it not like Excel, for example. This is the point there. And yes, also, you know, my best tip would be, like you said, to start with yes, not so many colors. I like to start with gray, black, blue and red for the values, and maybe then for example, for the header, change it to the corporate identity or something else. But so that's the colors I choose often here to start, and then to get in development with the department. And yes, I think, as I mentioned, you can not always, well, you must try to follow these points I mentioned, but I think you can't even fulfill all the points.
Yeah, I think the HPCS rules you mentioned, they like prefer to like use black and gray for actual values, the normal ones, and then to use one signature color, like the corporate color, it might be anything but red or green, and then to use red or green for deviations, which you already modified, like you don't need to, it's a problem to use red or red and green sometimes. So when they really I'm not really colorblind, but a little bit weakness in red or green. So if they are not intense, I also cannot distinguish them. But for me, it's only a problem with fonts, not so much with.
Or you can use icons sometimes, depending on the use case. Sometimes icons also work in my experience, so because they are more like, then you are not only depending on the color. You can combine that, of course, but that doesn't fit for every use case. If you have a matrix with 10 columns and every column has icons in it, then you probably also don't want that. So
I can actually show something. It's real. Like one report I redesigned, not now, it was redesigned before, but this is an example. So earlier I really liked the candy colors in demos, and obviously the people just don't understood it, and I was thinking, oh, why it's so great if I, you know, if you see 2016 here, it's the same color in all the other charts, so you have a high information density because the colors are the same in all of these bars, but it's still, you know, it's still confusing why the years are different. It's not like people are commonly used. So I just redesigned it in a quite boring way, but in my experience, more understandable. And even here, it's questionable why the ones are red and the others are blue. It's much better to have everything in one color. And I think because it's the, it's not the same visual, I cannot change the colors at once. So even here, it would be better to use the theme generator. I think when I have the same kind of visual, I can do everything here, because it's the same, and then I can, this new one is quite cool, the new menu bar, but it's still, you know, you have so much space for formatting, and in the theme generator, you have all the space you need. So of course, I think if you have to format more than one or two visuals, you're faster with the theme generator, because I'm already here searching for colors and I don't find this when I here. No, it's just writings. I have to mark one of them and then look for my colors. So it's really not so easy. And yeah, this is, I think, one of the pains you have with Power BI if you do format, because I don't know what's your experience, but if you have like projects, you focus on the hard stuff, like on the techniques and that all the data works, all the measures work, and then the budget is done and everything, the project is over, you need to be in another project, and then yeah, okay, the formatting is just not so important. But it's not so important for you as a creator, maybe, because you have created it, you understand that the candy colors, what they actually mean. But the target group does not understand it, or not always. So it was quite a fun project. I shown it a student of me, and she said, okay, it's confusing, and like reformatted it to some gray stuff. I cannot show it now, unfortunately. It's not anonymized, her version, but it was still like, okay, so it's not so great after all to use everything. And this was even clean. It's besides the colors, it's quite okay. I have much worse sites to show like this, where it's obviously a lots of problems, but this is like a demo that is made to be bad, actually. What you don't show, actually, what is the meaning of this? You can read one, two, maybe three, the rest is not important. So can you see the difference between India and Italy? It's the same size. Why
that's
then,
for example, one we don't recommend to use pie charts.
Yeah, this is
I remember a course from SQL BI, yeah. And they also said, like, don't use pie charts.
isn't this much better, even if you can do it more, and just with a little, I will make it more sick, because nobody is interested in, this is...
I mean, you could cover this also, like, yeah. For example, there was, yeah. Like, you could show top X values, mm-hmm. and then you could have a category or others. That's more into the DAX part,
yeah,
how you
yeah.
do this. But
then you have to
also
calculate a lot. But of course, if I just don't want to hide, so sometimes I really prefer to hide instead of do top X, because if someone likes it here, it's not hidden. It's just cheap made, because of the sickness. It is just top six because of the sickness. It's not, but I know Marco Russo and Alberto Ferrari done like a much more sophisticated version where the others are separate chart.
But it's like what to say, like, it always depends on the context, what works best for your report. And
yes.
Sorry.
As I said, sorry. I think it can also be helpful to involve the users in the creation part, and not to give the consumers of the report, so here's the result and have fun with it. So I think to involve it in the process of creating the report, and also I think that this is one of the most valuable tips, I think.
And also number formatting, it's not directly tied to the theme formatting, but also make sure that the formats fit. Sometimes you have these options. Is it like you have it in the data or none, or with 1,000 values that the numbers are not that big? Also try to make this consistent across your report. It's like, it's easy tips, but I've seen so many reports that were great under the hood, but it was just so hard to read, because also the charts were not separated like here, where you see like, okay, here the chart ends, the other chart begins. And this can really sometimes, if a person that is not a data person goes to the report, and it's just a barrier, and then you lower the acceptance also of reports, and then they are, I don't understand this. So,
and then there is even some more provocative rule, then good charts don't need a legend, so it's an exception here. But here, okay, it's already inside, and this is also in contrast to this. So why do you have a legend here if you have the same here? You cannot read any of it, so it's useless anyway. So why you just take the space. And good reports do not need a lot of slices normally. It's better to make like separate sites for some topics, but this is quite controversial. So I also not a person that does not use any slices at all. I use them because clients want it. But yeah, if you see that there's not enough space for slices, the problem is maybe not the space, but your report design, because this is just outsourcing part of your report design to the user because of poor design. So the user is just forced to cross filter and to search product groups and everything. Yeah, sometimes you need to focus on great stuff. I even have more like monsters in this. Now this is quite okay. It's not very repaired here. Maybe this. Oh no, but that's what, yeah.
What I also like to use sometimes is tooltips to hover over. You can also use charts as a tooltip. So then it automatically filters to what you have. So for example, here, if you would hover over the 2017 year, then you could have a chart that is top countries in 2017 or something already filtered. And this sometimes also helps for information that you don't need at first glance, or where you just want to see, okay, what was the best performing product or something. Then you can hide this there and make it nice for the user. It also comes with some downsides. Sometimes it depends, but yeah. Again, it depends on the context. There was one question from Andrea, but you already answered it, Thomas. Maybe also for the people later watching the recording, the planning to adopt the features of formatting text.
So as I said, we are planning to implement the new features, but I must say we implement and develop the theme generator alongside our main projects. So we have to find time, but I think in the yet next year we get to start. There's the big problem in further implementing or development the theme generator was there's no documentation how the JSON has to look like and what are the settings named in the JSON to set for, and there are settings for example for the title color there are different names for different visuals, so that's really really frustrating when you're developing, and it takes a long time. And I hope Microsoft changed not the whole JSON file now. So we will see. But we are planning, we're definitely planning to develop it further. So, yes.
Okay, great. Yeah. So, yeah, again, recording will be available. Don't worry. And maybe we will also share the links again, where you can also give feedback directly to Thomas. You can also also reach out to Arthur or me, and we will then.
I have one more question.
Yeah, sure.
So the external tools are hyped a lot. I think why do you decide to make a web tool and not an external tool in Power BI?
I think. I can give you a short answer. My company is a business intelligence company, and we are developing web applications. So web applications was the first. So
okay, yeah. So I like it personally, but I know sometimes it's more.
Maybe it's a good idea to when we implement it further. So why not?
Because it's like just a hype when I compare how often I used the DAX Studio before it was integrated, and afterwards it's quite a change.
But it's I like web apps more because they are better to update, and I update once time, and every user gets the update, and so on. So, but maybe it's a good idea.
Yeah, but this is what not really criticism, just thinking. I think it's a good explanation that you're good in web application and the update cycle is quite higher than along the bigger tools like Tabula Editor.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Then thank you, Thomas, for the presentation. Thank you
for invitation.
Everyone for joining. And that was the last event for this year. So, and we will see you back in January. So don't worry. More meetups are definitely coming.
Thanks for attending. In January, we might plan. So I think it's already in planning. The Chris Kokusa comes back with the performance topic. Then our DAX workshop will also come back in some kind. We will still discuss it, but there will be something about DAX. We are also still planning to do a recap of the three past DAX sessions that we will upload on the YouTube channel. So if anyone has not yet subscribed, then hit the subscribe button to the German Meetups channel.
Like and subscribe.
Yeah, there you have almost all cities of Germany with the Power Platform Meetups. Yeah. Lots of good stuff. Yeah, and then see you again. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to everyone.
Yes.
Bye.
I will not see some other meetups. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye.